One of the things we're doing together ensemble is to equip you with new skills which seem to be particularly relevant to our times. Yes, in this session, we chose to address the issue of addiction. It might look a bit extreme, but we think we have a duty here to launch uncomfortable conversations to provoke a global awakening. We think we have a duty to identify the actions we have to undertake for the benefit of the next generations. With this other topic today, we make it clear that we have to shift our culture, or the most vulnerable among us will continue to be the most hit in our society, as inequality is systemic. And so, as we could see in the recording, addiction is really the end of the spectrum of being caught up. It's often a negative habit that we develop gradually without really noticing the harm, whether on us or others or even the planet. And when we are disconnected from ourselves, it's even more difficult to see. So sometimes we have all the evidence that it is harmful, but we continue since others, people we trust and love around us, are doing the same and seem to be doing quite fine actually with it. It's fun, it's cool, they look beautiful, they look happier. We can even think that thanks to the external object we use, we'll grow our strengths, our control, it's good. But unfortunately, comes the day when what was seen as a relatively harmless habit, or as I showed there, sometimes perceived as rewarding, can suddenly become uncontrollable. You have entered one day the cycle of addiction and things seem getting out of hand. The object of addiction is overruling your life. You think about it most of the time, even your actions, consciously or unconsciously, lead towards the object of addiction. So when you fall in this trap, let me say this is very, very hard, almost impossible when governed by a judgmental and blaming culture to come back to a healthy life. Sometimes it's not even the object of addiction that is really the problem, but the pattern you have adopted with it. Let me give you an illustration to explain this pattern. Let's say you are an overeater and you want to lose weight. You develop great self-discipline. You are super motivated to heal from the negative habit of eating too much. But at this stage, you are not aware that the problem is not the object of addiction, but the addiction pattern in itself. And so you choose with the best intention to replace the craving by introducing more physical activities or cooking time. But the addictive behavior does not disappear by magic. It's inside you, and this new activity starts to overrule your life. And so you will start to do too much physical activity, which is certainly not good, as it is proven to make people die sooner. Or you will impact the quality of your family relationship by spending most of your time cooking, isolated in the kitchen. What I'm saying here is that faced with an addiction, there's no other option than to seek professional support. You won't manage on your own. And this is why, as Olivier was suggesting, there's no other way than to explore seriously the forest behind the tree. And this requires shift. And from research, we know this will require a massive amount of energy when we have not been equipped for that, or when the conditions are not there to support our healing. That question actually was addressed at the societal level in Iceland to reduce the number of addictive behaviors among adolescents. This initiative is very inspiring, as it led to amazing results. Let me share with you useful steps you can undertake inspired from research and this initiative when faced with a bad habit. Again, when faced with an addiction, we recommend seeking professional support. First, become aware that the reward you get from the object of addiction is not as good as you think it is. Second, you can use visualization techniques and stimulate your imagination. What you want is to live an experience of disgust with your body. You can ask the help of a professional for that. Third, find another activity to answer the craving, which would be more rewarding. Ideally, again, as the body heals the mind, you can choose an activity that will make your body expand instead of getting tense. And so progressively, your body will tell your mind, that's the state I want. I want more well-being. Please let me come back to positive habits. Four, introduce the habit of creating spaces in your life for deep breathing, mindfulness, mental fitness, yoga postures, music, anything that can delay the action following the craving will do good to you, because we are used in our modern society to have immediate pleasure when we want, but we really have to fight that. It's bad for us. We have to use more our neocortex, our rational brain. We need to stop working in automatic mode most of our days. Five, as it was mentioned a number of times during the recording, socialization and links, connection, they are all good for you. Enjoy the social life. You do not exist by yourself. It's a myth and one of the illusions of our post-industrial era. No, we are not isolated individuals struggling to be loved. Love is everywhere. Open your eyes, create communities and working groups. Finally, if the mountain looks really, really big for you, there are many techniques you can use to make it much easier, like working in small steps, joining a group, developing spiritual energy, following a process that is not to be working like the AA, finding psychological support, make it a priority to be a Sherlock Holmes and explore the forest, enjoy the treasure hunt. What we want to pass as a message with this episode is continue the talk. From experience, we have to do everything we can to leave the cycle of addiction before it is too late, which is often before you become sick, basically, because there the stress and negative emotions are way too overwhelming to find the energy to dominate the elephant in the room. And what we know also from research is the only way to break a sequence of addiction, if you have one in your family, is to heal yourself, to be a role model for others around you, to inspire them to heal as well and break the pattern. When you see an addictive pattern in people around you, it may say a lot more than you think about your own patterns. So if you want to heal our society, leave a great gift to your children. Let's heal yourself right now. Thank you.